Sometimes in Commander, cards can act in such a synergistic and powerful way that they can help you achieve infinite power! In this video, I want to take a look at 5 infinite damage combos that only require the color black in your commander deck, and the video starts right now. Special thanks to our Patreon supporters who power our channel. Check out our Patreon for monthly giveaways, exclusive content, and even a starring role in our fan fight series. Link in the description below.
For a limited time only, if you join the Patreon at any level, you will receive a holographic Jake and Joel R. Magic logo sticker. Link in the description below.
Hello and welcome to the day. Thank you for spending your time with us. Welcome back to another episode of Jake and Joel R. Magic. I am Joel. We're going to look at 5 infinite damage combos that you only need the color black in your commander deck to pull off. But first, if you would, go down there, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button if you like the video by the end of it. It really helps us out. Let's jump into some infinite damage combos in black. So first up, we have got one that requires Giraffe's Messenger, Ashnod's Altar, and Nim Deathmantle. Altar Deathmantle combos in Commander are fairly common, but this one only additionally requires the use of Giraffe's Messenger to pull off an infinite damage combo that's going to help you win right then and there. So to get this combo started, we need all 3 of these permanents on the battlefield. What we're going to do is we're going to sacrifice Giraffe's Messenger to Ashnod's Altar. That's going to add 2 colorless mana to our mana pool. Giraffe's Messenger is going to trigger itself, returning to the battlefield with a +1/+1 counter on it because of undying. When this creature dies, if it had no +1/+1 counters on it, return it to the battlefield under its owner's control with a +1/+1 counter on it. When it enters the battlefield, target opponent is going to lose 2 life, so that is the damage trigger that we're looking for so that we can eventually burn everybody down. We have 2 colorless mana floating as a result of this interaction. Next, we sacrifice Giraffe's Messenger once again to Ashnod's Altar, adding an additional 2 mana to our mana pool. Now that we've got this card in the graveyard, it didn't trigger Undying again on itself. We've got 4 mana floating, so we're able to activate Nim Deathmantle. Whenever a non-token creature is put into your graveyard from the battlefield, you may pay 4. If you do, return that card to the battlefield and attach Nim Deathmantle to it. So now we have a Giraffe's Messenger that has returned to the battlefield again, dealt 2 damage or had an opponent lose 2 life. It's obviously going to enter the battlefield tapped, but that really doesn't matter for this because at this point we do this again. Giraffe's Messenger, we sacrifice it to Ashnod's Altar for 2 mana. Giraffe's Messenger returns itself with a +1/+1 counter on it. Target opponent loses 2 life. We then sacrifice it to Ashnod's Altar again, achieving 4 mana floating. We activate Nim Deathmantle, returning Giraffe's Messenger to the battlefield, having another opponent lose 2 life, and we do this infinitely until we win. The next one I want to show you is going to achieve near infinite damage, and it requires Necrotic Ooze, Triskelion, and Phyrexian Devourer. So to get this combo rolling, we need Necrotic Ooze on the battlefield. All of the other cards are going to be in the graveyard. I'm just going to leave them right here for easy access while we're running this combo so you can see. But these 2 are in our graveyard, and we need the combined CMC of cards in our library to be greater than or equal to the sum of our opponent's life totals. So if they're all still at 40, we need at least 120 converted CMC total in our library. That's only notable as we go through it because of Phyrexian Devourer's abilities. And if you've got enough cards left in your library, you're probably going to be able to pull this off. So with Necrotic Ooze on the battlefield, it's going to say it has all activated abilities of all creature cards in all graveyards. And really, we only care about the activated abilities of Phyrexian Devourer and Triskelion. Phyrexian Devourer's activated ability is pay 0, remove the top card of your library from the game to put a +1/+1 counter on Phyrexian Devourer where X is equal to the card's casting cost. It's going to put a number of +1/+1 counters on this card according to the Oracle text. Triskelion's activated ability says remove a +1/+1 counter from Triskelion. It deals 1 damage to target creature or player. So we're going to activate Phyrexian Devourer's ability through Necrotic Ooze. So we're going to activate Necrotic Ooze's ability, which is Phyrexian Devourer's activated ability. We're going to activate that repeatedly to exile our entire library, adding a number of counters to Necrotic Ooze equal to the CMC of the exiled cards. Really, our goal is just to get this, if everybody's still at their starting life totals, get this up to 120 so that we can fire off these +1/+1 counters with Triskelion remove a +1/+1 counter from it, deal 1 damage to target creature or player, which Necrotic Ooze has because these are in the graveyard. We're going to add a ton of +1/+1 counters to Necrotic Ooze, and then use our other activated ability that we're stealing from Triskelion to then deal all that damage to our opponents. Again, the only limitation on this is that you've got enough cards in your library when you assemble this combo and you're ready to go, which is Necrotic Ooze on the battlefield and Devourer and Triskelion in the graveyard. You only need enough CMC total across all cards in your deck to shoot your opponent's life totals down, whatever they may be at that time. So for the next combo, I want to cover a classic. This card combo is just so ubiquitous, I think, with infinite damage discussions. It's Machaos the Unhallowed and Triskelion. We need both cards to be on the battlefield, and then we are ready to go. This is just a nice little two-card infinite damage combo. We're going to remove all the counters that Triskelion has on it to deal 1 damage to an opponent and 2 damage to itself. That's going to kill itself, but when it dies, Machaos's ability, other non-human creatures you control get +1/+1 and have undying, is going to trigger, and Triskelion is going to return to the battlefield with a +1/+1 counter on it, in addition to the 3 that it enters with, just based on its own ETB. Triskelion enters the battlefield with 3 +1/+1 counters on it. Then we repeat this cycle and we ping our opponents to death. We just always need to make sure that we save the last 2 counters on Triskelion so that Triskelion can kill itself, and then it's going to return. It's going to check. When it dies, it won't have a +1/+1 counter on it at this point because we will have taken all of them off to kill itself, even though it does get +1/+1 with Machaos. The math works out. We remove all the +1/+1 counters on it, deal 1 damage to an opponent, 2 damage to itself. When it comes back with Machaos' undying ability, it's going to have 4 +1/+1 counters on it. We deal 1 of those to an opponent, we do 3 to itself so that it kills itself, and we're able to come back an infinite amount of times with Machaos the Unhallowed on the battlefield, and Triskelion is able to just kind of machine gun our opponents down. So this next one is going to be the most complicated one to explain how to pull off, but essentially it is a doomsday you win the game combo. To get this one started, we need Commander Sphere on the battlefield, we need Doomsday in our hand, we need a lot of mana, we need 9 mana, and we need Bolas's Citadel, Black Sun Zenith, and Aetherflux Reservoir in our library or graveyard, and then 2 other cards with CMC very low. It doesn't matter what the 2 other cards are, as long as they're like 2 mana or just 1 mana to cast, because those will end up going into our Doomsday pile. To kick this off, we're going to cast Doomsday. 3 black mana, search your library and graveyard for 5 cards of your choice and remove the rest from the game. Put the chosen cards on top of your library in any order you choose. You lose half of your life rounded up. So Doomsday is going to resolve, and we're going to go find Bolas's Citadel, Black Sun Zenith, and Aetherflux Reservoir, plus 2 other cards, like I said, with low CMC, just because we're going to need mana. We're going to need life to cast those cards with Bolas's Citadel. So we've paid our 3 for the Doomsday. We're going to stack the cards for Doomsday like this. Citadel needs to be the first card that we draw. After that, we need to draw Reservoir, and then we need to draw 2 of whatever cards we have that are low CMC, 1 mana, 2 mana, something like that. And then lastly, we're going to have Black Sun Zenith. So we've got a stack of Doomsday that sort of looks like this, with 2 other cards that are low CMC in between Aetherflux Reservoir and Black Sun Zenith. Now, we are going to sacrifice Commander Sphere to draw a card, and that's what's going to really get this going. All of this other stuff has been exiled. Bolas's Citadel we can play for the 6 mana that we've got available, and from there on out we don't need mana to cast cards because we've got Bolas's Citadel on the battlefield. You may play the top card of your library, and if you cast a spell this way, pay life equal to the converted mana cost rather than pay its mana cost. So we pay 4 life to cast Aetherflux Reservoir, then we pay hopefully 3 or 4 life, something very low, to get the other creatures or cards onto the battlefield. Because we have Aetherflux Reservoir on the battlefield now, as we're casting spells, we're exponentially gaining more and more life with each spell that is cast. So when we cast that low CMC spell first, we gained a life. When we cast another low CMC spell, we gain 2 life, and then it'll be 3, and then 4, and then so forth. We're down to just Black Sun Zenith in our library at this time. We've cast Bolas's Citadel, Aetherflux Reservoir, those 2 other spells, and Black Sun Zenith is now right there. So we've got enough life at this point to cast Black Sun Zenith for 0, and that's fine, because when it resolves for just the four life or two black mana, however we're casting it, it's going to say shuffle Black Sun Zenith into its owner's library. Because we're gaining life at an exponentially higher rate every single time we cast another spell, Black Sun Zenith is back on top of our library. We can cast it with Bolas's Citadel by just paying the life, so it would be two life to cast Black Sun Zenith again. It gives us another storm trigger, so Aetherflux Reservoir is gaining us more life that cast. Black Sun Zenith goes back to the top of the library, and we repeat that an infinite amount of times, gaining an infinite amount of life off of our infinite casts of Black Sun Zenith, and then we use Aetherflux Reservoir, as you've seen in many of these combo kills, to pay the 50 life per player, deal 50 damage to them, and we win the game. So that last combo is one of my favorite Doomsday piles. Let me know in the comments below what your Doomsday pile is and how you win once you've cast that card, because it's pretty straightforward to find five cards that interact in a way with your Doomsday pile of choice to win the game as you're playing that card. So for the final combo, I want to show you another Altar and Blood Artist infinite loop that you can create with these four cards on the battlefield. Blood Artist, Reassembling Skeleton, Carnival of Souls, and Ashnod's Altar. We'll also need a swamp just so we can make one black mana and we'll be good to go. So what we do to run this whole combo is we sacrifice the Reassembling Skeleton to Ashnod's Altar. That's going to create two colorless mana and trigger Blood Artist, dealing a damage to target player, and we gain a life. At that point, we're good to go. With Reassembling Skeleton, we have two colorless mana in our mana pool. We just need one black so that we can activate Reassembling Skeleton and return it from our graveyard to the battlefield tapped. When a creature comes into play on our side with Carnival of Souls, we're going to lose a life and we're going to add one swamp to our mana pool. And then we run the combo again. We sacrifice Reassembling Skeleton, Ashnod's Altar gives us two colorless mana, Blood Artist is going to have a target player lose a life and we gain a life, which is what we need with Carnival of Souls on the battlefield. We use the black mana that we had floating from Carnival of Souls to recast Reassembling Skeleton onto the battlefield tapped. It enters, we lose a life, which we've gained from Blood Artist. We add a swamp to our mana pool and so forth. Sacrifice, deal the damage. We have the mana, recast Reassembling Skeleton, and we have a loop that is going to Blood Artist all of our opponents down and win the game just with these four very low CMC permanents on the battlefield. That's five infinite damage combos in the color black for EDH. Let's close the book. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. Like I said, if you wouldn't mind, go down there, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button if you like the video. If there is a infinite damage combo in the color black for Commander that I missed, let me know down in the comments below. I'd love for the conversation to continue. If you want to check out our other infinite power videos, you should. We have a playlist with some infinite damage combos, with some turn one win combos, lots of fun stuff. It's a silly playlist, but we have a lot of fun making the videos. So go check that out and see if you like it. Other than that, I'm tapped out and I'll catch you later.